Most camps focus on either sports or educational. This one does both of them.
Having a really great time.
We've been doing a lot of stuff.
It's very fun. You learn a lot of stuff.
More than any other camp that you ever been to.
I'm having a great time at this camp.
A really good time.
You should come.
Come and bring your friends.
I'm Anthony, and I flip for Foundation Camp.
Foundation Camp is a two-week camp for boys and young men between the ages of 10 and 14. It's completely free.
We've expanded our program. We're almost at 100 kids now for 2 weeks. Enrollment's been good. The attitude of our staff and all to help the kids and motivate them to be successful in life is really working out well.
It's amazing when you take kids that are perceived to be at risk, kids that don't necessarily do well or traditionally do well in the areas of math and science, but at our camp, they just love it.
The campers, they look forward to this camp. They love being with their friends. They love playing sports. They love just being here at the Foundation Camp.
Even though we have sporting activities, that is not the primary drive of our camp. Our camp is really about creating an academic environment, but a fun environment where kids can learn and participate in these academic endeavors and not realize that they're actually learning.
Most camps focus on either sports or educational. This one does both of them.
It's more than any other camp that you ever been to. You got canoeing, you get the tie-dye shirts, play basketball, flag football, tennis, everything you can ask for. It's just more than what you expect.
You know, a lot of these children we have have the ability to learn and be successful. We want them to understand that, there's a place for them to succeed. We want them to overcome their obstacles. A lot of us would fall flat on our faces if we had to face the obstacles that these young people have to.
Low self-esteem. See, when we put them clothes on.
And I believe with this count, we're giving back to the community and we're steering a lot of young men down a path that has college in mind.
They're engaged, they're reading, they're participating, showing great teamwork. And these are characteristics that they need to be successful in school, that some of them struggle when it comes to that environment. So the camp is clearly a positive environment that allows these kids to really develop into who they truly can be.
And I already see a lot of improvement in behavior. The campers will greet you, shake hands, introduce themselves.
He taught us how to tie a tie, so when we go to do an interview, we can look presentable instead of coming up in baggy shorts or just any kind of shirt.
And learning a lot of stuff about how man can be successful without making bad mistakes in our life.
We had a biology class where we got to look at like organs in the organ system.
Well, we did a poetry component. Well, Dr. Hershey, actually using Langston Hughes, I Known Rivers, did a seminar on poetry and expressing ourselves through prose. And from that, we actually produced our own poetry book, our first Foundation Camp poetry book.
It's been a great success, and I think it's a camp that does a tremendous service for not only the young men who participate, but for the community also.
The camp is funded primarily through private donations. We have been fortunate to have some sponsors that have sponsored us every year, but we still require a lot of funding.
We are very proud of our campers this year. They've done an excellent job, but we could not get it done without your donations.
We're going to do this in one or two ways. These children are going to be brought to this campus, and we're going to do the best we can to make these people successful. But if we don't, we're going to be paying for this on the back end.
We are proud that for 2 weeks we provide meals, we provide transportation, we provide everything free to our students, but it costs money. And that's what we rely on the community. We hope the community see this as an asset. It's an investment that will pay off in the years to come, because these students could become the next mayor, the next chief of police, the next school teacher, superintendent. These students could become, will become the next leaders of our community, whether it's good or bad.
You know, these children of no fault of their own sometimes do not have the people at home to help monitor them, to guide them through life. This just is part of us as a community effort to see if we can get these kids to be successful. Most of these kids have the ability to be successful. They have the drive and they want to be. They don't want to be stuck in the situation that they are now. I think we can really make a difference in young people's lives if we just nurture their dreams one at a time. I think we'll make a huge difference for our community as a whole.